Selamat datang dan selamat sejahtera kepada semua. Okay, I am Fahrizal Zulkarnain. My title is analysis of polypropylene fiber to tension strength in housing construction. Okay, the research is knowing the comparison of the addition of polypropylene fiber is 0.3% and 0.7% and 1% with 1SP super plasticizer chemical like viscocrete 8670 mn on the split tensile strength test and elastic modulus test on normal concrete. Knowing the effect of adding polypropylene fiber to the normal concrete. Research method is a concrete specimen we produce by adding polypropylene fiber and viscocrete in the form of a cylinder with the 15 cm diameter and 30 cm height to conduct this experiment. The polypropylene fibers were varied at the 0%, 0.3, 0.7, and 1%. Moreover, the tensile strength and modulus of elasticity were tested when the concrete reached 28 days. And then all the material in the concrete, such as the fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, cement, water, and polypropylene fiber added were used in the determining the value of the modulus of elasticity. Okay, this picture we call the polypropylene fiber. In this basic raw material, often use the manufactured plastic base goods. And it is a hydrocarbon chemical compound C3H6, which form a single filament or a network of thin fibers, such as a net with a length between 6 millimeter to 15 millimeter and a diameter 19 millimeter. Then this picture, we can mix all the material in the concrete, such as the fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, the cement, and water, and the polypropylene fiber that we use in determining the value of the modulus of elasticity. Fresh concrete with added polypropylene fiber and viscocrete 8670 mn. If we mix all the material, we can see the fiber can mix together with the all the cement and all the fine aggregate. And then if we go to slum test and we get the 10 cm for the length, and for this research, I think a good result and for the 28 days. This slum test, we take the picture slum test and all the, let's say the all the material can mix together. Then the slump test around the 9 to 10 centimeter. And the second picture, all the sample can prepare to the mold, and we wait to the 28 day before we test the compressive. Get the modulus dust and the compressive track. This concrete variation, this the normal concrete FAS and the slum test at 0.45, and we get the slum in the 16 millimeter. And BPF polypropylene fiber concrete with the one face concrete super plastic saja, same the 0.3 0.7 and 1% is the polypropylene fiber, and we just different polypropylene and the same super plasticizer face concrete 8670 mm, and we get the slum value 60, 53, 50 and 46 millimeter. And the second pictures with slum test result, we get the decrease. Yeah, if we take the more than 0.7% polypropylene fiber, we can get the slum value is decreased, like the second picture is 50 millimeter, and if we take 1% and decrease also, then the value is 46 millimeter. And this the example, you can get the every sample we can take one by one for the example. And then this the installation of capping on the concrete before the experiment. The capping is the yellow color, is the top of the cylinder, and then we can go to the experiment. And then the soak sample, all the sample we can soak before experiment. We can know, we get the absorption or no about the sample. If we take more absorption, based on the literature review, we can get the value decrease for the 28 days. The analysis, the need for the concrete constituent for a wide variety of mixtures. One is the NC, the normal concrete, is code of the test object, and the 0.01166, and the cement is 4.793 kilogram. The fine aggregate, the 8.493 kilogram, and then cost aggregate, the 12.425. And water 2.323 kilogram, polypropylene fiber 0, and this is concrete 0. This is we call the normal concrete. And then number 2, number 3, then number 4, we can mix for the meter cube all the sample. Then the total is the volume is 0.04664 meter cube, and the cement 19.17 kilogram, fine aggregate 33.97 kilogram, and the coarse aggregate 49.700 gram, and then water 9.292 kilogram, polypropylene fiber 0.0957, and viscocrete 8670 mm 0.1437. And this split tensile strength of concrete is the normal is the English is a normal concrete NC. Number 2 is 0.3 0.7 until 1%. this is variation, and this dish, the same dish, 28 dish, and then surface area, the same millimeter square, and this load and the by ton, this is 166.72 until 10.5012969, and then tensile strength, this the with megapascal units, and we get the 2.36 MPa, and then 2.5, and we can get the average, this the we get the 2.4 megapascal, and then BPF 0.3 we got the 2.6 MPa, 0.7 we get 2.1 MPa, and then 1% we get the 1.32 megapascal. This is important because the tensile strength of concrete is relatively low and estimate to be 10% to 15% and sometimes get the 20% of the compressive strength. The power is more difficult to measure and the result vary from one experimental material to another in comparison with the pressure cylinders. Okay, next slide is the test results with tensile strength of concrete. The picture is the normal concrete polypropylene fiber concrete 0.3, 0.7, and the last one is 1%. And the split tensile test, we get the 2.43, 2.6, and then decrease 2.085, and the last one 1.32. Okay, the 0.3% BPF variation experience an increase in tensile strength. This show that the add condition of polypropylene fiber into the concrete matrix can increase the tensile strength of concrete. This increase in tensile strength is influenced by the contribution of polypropylene fiber, which function as a bridge bridging action, so that concrete can be ductile in bearing loads. However, the BPF variation of 0.7% and 1% is decreased. This is caused by the use of too high amount of polypropylene fiber content. The ratio of significant fiber can result in unsatisfactory characteristic of a fresh concrete, a mix that is not workable and does not undergo any compaction process can affect the quality of the concrete, so that is reduce the spilling tensile strength. Modulus of elasticity of concrete the same, they start from the normal concrete 0.3, 0.7, and 1%, but the modulus elasticity we get the increase the value of concrete like 35092 MPa until 97311 MPa for the 1% polypropylene fiber. And if we compare the normal concrete by the concrete compressive strength MPa then and the elastic modulus, we can get the different, what we call different result. Yeah, number one is the 0.3, 29.44 MPa to the 1% is 51.14, and 52864 to the 97.311 MPa. Okay, in this research, we try to get the SEM, scanning electron microscope. Now we get to the another lab in the University North of Sumatra. Then we try to take a sample in the top, middle, and the end of the cylinders, and then they get the microstructure of polypropylene fiber with the silica fume was determined using the scanning electron microscope with the 300 times and 1500 magnification. So the color of the color is the black one. I think superplasticizer and the polypropylene fiber not mix in all the material like a dot I think dot what call it there, get the problem mix or another things. Maybe the next research we can prepare for the diameter of polypropylene in the small size. Because if we get the 90 millimeter or more, we can get the same result from the SEM scanning electron microscope. Okay, the next continue. The SEM focus on the topography, which is the characteristic of the surface and texture, followed by the morphology, which emphasize the shape of and the size of the particles, and the composition, which is the semi-quantitative data on the elements and compound contained in the object. It can be seen that there is a build up of a fiber in certain parts of the concrete mixer. This is due to the lack of integration of the mixer with polypropylene fiber. And then we get the second picture is like a crowded, I think. Dr. Zaharina, I think all the material not be compact together general mix. Okay, the hole, yeah, the hole, the main hole, the small hole, that is, can get the same analysis part two, maybe for the result in the good result. Okay, the last slide is the conclusion. The analysis conduct so that the 0.3 BPF concrete sample had to the highest split tensile strength with the 2.6 megapascal, followed by the normal concrete with 2.4 MPa and the 0.7% BPF with 2.1 MPa and 1% BPF with the 1.3 MPa. This show that the inclusion the more fiber because to lower split tensile strength for the concrete. And the second one, it was always discovered that the modulus of elasticity increase with the content of fiber in the concrete mix, such that the normal concrete had to 35.902 megapascal, while the 0.3% BPF record the 5287564 megapascal, 0.7% BPF hard to 84.926 megapascal, and the 1% BPF hard to 97311 megapascal. That mean the this mean the elasticity modulus of the okay increase with the content of fiber used. This is the line with the characteristic of polypropylene fiber which has a modulus of elasticity above 9000 MPa. It is, however, also important to note that a lower slump value usually leads to lower workability. Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you very much for the presentation. So now we open for questions. Is there any question for Dr. Fahrizal? Any question?
I think no, Dr. Azarina.
Okay, if there are no more questions, thank you very much to all three speakers for today webinar. So with this, we'll end our webinar for today. Again, our faculty would like to gratitude all the speakers from University of Universitas Muhammadiyah Sumatera Utara. Okay, thank you everyone.
Thank you, Dr. Thank you. Okay.